with us. We're literally occupying the building. We are literally there. They had to sleep by the boiler just to get the boiler man there. This is serious.
Okay, so in this building, we have harassment of mothers, children. I've gone through it. Okay, well, the police are not going to do anything. So, and some, I'm just letting you know.
Right.
And some, and no intelligence in the world is going to deal with some of these people.
Thank you.
I'm just letting you know.
We have people.
Even though we're not going there.
Right, we have people on staff. Shabukwe?
Yeah. I guess it's a question. Because I'm like 2.5 weeks. I'm relatively new to the entire movement. And again, you know, I'm not just a black face that they sent up here. I'm like, cause I knew that some needs would be missing, and I was evicted out of Harlem, so I know exactly. And I've been to 477, and it was cold, and there was no hot water. Unfortunately, I couldn't find anybody but two other white individuals to help me bring up food. This is Friday night. But I didn't, you know, as long as we got it up there, that was the main thing. But my question was, I guess, directly response is to, you work with other, basically, communities of color. I've been to West Harlem, GA, and I've been to the Bronx. So you also work, because I know they also working with other issues, dealing with housing and police brutality.
Right.
So I just wanted to be clear on that. So you go to different GAs and things of that nature?
Right, we do as much as we can. And that's all anybody can ask from anyone. Mm-hmm. You know, we do what we can. You know, basically all we are is just two brothers that just got off the porch. All right? No, I'm serious. That's all it was. That's all it is. You know, so we do what we can. We go everywhere that we can because we can't be everywhere. But you know, it's not only us. Like, you know, there's other people. You might see people and you don't even know that, you know, that they're part of it. You understand? But what I'm saying is I don't know if I'm answering your question.
Right.
But if you ask me if we go to other GAs and if we, you know, yeah, we do as many as we can. You know, have we been to all of them? No.
You work particularly with communities of color and marginalized communities.
Well, that's our focus.
Okay.
That's our focus.
It's occupying the hood.
It's right. And the reason why that's the focus is just like him. I've been at OWS since I don't want to say day one, but pretty much the first week, right? Now here's the truth. The truth is this: Occupy Wall Street doesn't.
I'm sorry.
All right, that's it. We're done.
Okay,
right.
Who's next?
Hans.
Just to continue on some of the points that I think that are being made, I think for me, there needs to be a little bit more structure. There has to be, for example, we have West Harlem, Occupy West Harlem, or so on. There needs to be these kinds of liaisons that are establishing these kinds of direct contacts, and in order to really bolster these kinds of these things, because no one group here is going to be able to manage 20, 30, you know, buildings if you don't expand your capacity, and that needs to be done with joint sort of processes and discussions and moving forward. I did want to make a point on outreach, and because I'm part of outreach over there at OWS, but I could make it afterwards. If you want me to make it now, I can do it now.
Can we?
As a person that studied many and interacted with many of the Occupy Wall Street groups, working groups, I want to ask you about two in particular. Two in particular that they have is an alternative economy working group and an alternative banking working group. My question is, do you think that there needs to be in the hood a philosophy leaning towards an alternative economy and alternative banking and or capital formation?
Real quick, I believe in cooperative living, so banking would be one. We just came from Detroit, and I know people in Detroit who have been living for 20 years without using cash. Mm-hmm. They are literally living off the grid. So do I believe that we should put our monies in small banks
or credit unions that
tend to our needs? Of course.
Mm-hmm.
This is where I come from, a neighborhood. I'm from South Jamaica, Queens. Mm-hmm. Carver Bank was on the corner of my block. It's mm-hmm. no longer there.
That's right.
So I definitely think that we should return to that. I mean, this is what communities do. This is what our Jewish communities do. This is what our Italian communities do. This is, for some reason, we don't.
We used to.
Would you hold that thought just in terms of proposals, alternative economics in black communities? And very quickly, everybody knows that Wall Street now owns 75% of Carver Bank. It used to be the oldest black bank in the country, but it is no longer that. 75% of the stock is now owned by Wall Street. The bailout was $50 million. Mm. These are banks who received in the billions, and one bank at least $1 trillion in the $16 trillion bailout of the government. And they got that bank, which was really under an order from the feds because they said that they didn't have the capital because they made non-traditional loans at the height of the real estate boom to developers, to small developers here in Harlem and whatever, and people couldn't pay, became delinquent in those loans and mortgages, and the bailout was for a lousy $50 million, and they own now 75% of that bank. And I think the minority shareholders ownership is like less than 5%, I believe. Okay, who's next?